Hi, I'm Erik, and I'm here to look at how urbanization is affecting golf courses. In my travels around the world, I've noticed one thing. As cities grow, golf courses are basically in the wrong place. The golf courses are getting further and further away from golfers. So we're here to look at why that is.
I think the main issues with urban golf is just there's a lack of golf courses in certain places, and just to have really good facilities that are going to welcome people to the game.
I think golf is one of those sports where the stereotype of what golf is or what a golfer is so hard to redo. And that's why we really have to start thinking out of the box to give golf a different image, and not just one, but several images that people can aspire to.
So the first thing we need to do is take it out of the stigma that it's a posh-only sport, and not to see it as something prohibited because you weren't born privileged.
A lot of people say these days the words grow the game, and a lot of people talk about how golf is on a decline. Do you experience that, one, and two, where is that coming from? Is it true?
We're sitting in the middle of Los Angeles, California. Keep in mind that in this county, the supply was basically been fixed since the mid-1970s. So from the mid-1970s up until 2004, with a fixed supply, the demand went up. If highest and best value of all property in a place like Los Angeles was our watchword, we would have nothing but skyscrapers, we wouldn't have open space, we wouldn't have parks, and we wouldn't have municipal golf courses.
In Tokyo, most people will endure driving an hour and a half to maybe 2.5 hours to get to a golf course. Now, more and more, that's becoming difficult, and I don't think many younger potential golfers would be willing to do that. So the whole, I think, focus, especially myself, GDO, or even in the golf industry, is how do we expose more people to how fun golf could potentially be.
Club de Golf Mexico is the most private golf course in the city. It is also the busiest, and with 1,000 members, almost 1% of the entire golfing population of Mexico City belongs here. Tell me a little bit about golf in Mexico.
Yeah, so I think the right word is contrast. We are a country of a very big contrast, and golf is no exception. For example, Mexico City, we have probably between 10 and 12 courses around the area. 6 or 7 of them, you can find a very low income area next to a very well done golf club.
Right.
You know, and I think we need to take golf as an inclusion thing, but taking into account that there's a lot of disparity in the cities and no access to public golf.
We did find one public 9-hole course outside of the town that restored my hope in the idea that good golf in Mexico City could be introduced to not just the wealthy or the tourist.
¿Cómo está golf en México?
Sigue siendo muy elitista. Sigue solamente que tengas dinero puedes jugar. Realmente deberíamos tener más campos como este que permita que la gente desarrolle sus habilidades.
So as you can see, demographic changes are going to have a huge impact on the future of the game of golf. And it's on us to think differently to preserve this game for generations to come.